Let's discuss an example relating both transformation of vectors and gradient of vectors. Suppose we have a function f depend only on y and z. So gradient of f should be like this. For the transformation relation, we can write this. We have already shown this in our how the vectors transform video. So y bar should be like this and z bar should be like this from this relation. Y bar equal to cos phi y in plus sin phi z. So we have written like this. First we would like to multiply y bar with sin phi and we get this. Then we have multiply y bar with cos phi and we get this equation 3, and this is equation 1. First we have multiplied this z bar. Let's have a close look. Z bar equal to this. First we have multiplied z bar with cos phi and we get equation 2. Then we have multiplied sin phi z bar with sin phi and we get equation number 4. Then we got equation number 5 by just adding 1 and 2. That means we have added this and this. So we have added equation 1 and equation 2. So we got equation 5. Similarly, we have subtracted equation 3 and equation 4 and we got equation 6. Let's make some derivatives. If we make del y, del y bar will get cos phi only. For del y, del z bar we get minus sin phi only. Similarly, if we make del z, del y bar we get sin phi only, because if we want to make the derivative of equation phi with respect to y bar, we are left with only sin phi because cos phi terms involves z bar. Similarly, from equation phi we will get del z, del z bar. That means we need to differentiate this term only and we will get del z bar equal to cos phi. Let's define this term, which is gradient of this function. Y means y component of the gradient of del f, gradient of f. This thing, this bar means that this whole component is defined on the coordinate system y bar z bar, which we obtained by rotating y and z. So gradient of f suffix y, and this bar represents that on the coordinate system y bar z bar, which we got by rotation of yz coordinate system, and the component is the y component. So it's del f del y bar, because this is the y component, y bar component rather. So as f is function of both y and z variables, so it's del f del y into del y del y bar plus del f del z into del z del y bar. For del f del y, this is unchanged. We don't have any substitution for del f del y, but for del y bar, we have this relation, which is equal to del y bar equal to cos phi. So we have substituted cos phi for this. Similarly, for the second term, del z del y bar is substituted with del y, del z del y bar is sin phi. So del z del y bar is substituted with plus sin phi, substituted with plus sin phi, and this is del f del z. So this can be written as gradient of f, y component of gradient of f in the coordinate system yz, gradient of f I mean the z component of the gradient of f in the yz coordinate system. Similarly, for the z component of gradient of f in the y bar z bar coordinate system, we could write this, and we have substituted the values of del y del z bar and del z bar, what we have already derived. So we are getting this for the z component of gradient of f in the new coordinate system, that is the transformed coordinate system. So we have already derived the y component of gradient of f in the y bar z bar coordinate system, which is equal to this one. Under matrix notation, we could write the relation between the gradient of the function in yz coordinate system and y bar z bar coordinate system, and this is the rotation matrix. So this is nothing but is very much familiar and reminds us of the transformation relation for vectors. So gradient of a scalar function which we have claimed it's a vector quantity, this is actually a vector quantity as it is transforming like a vector. Tahole gradient of a scalar jake amra vector quantity hisabe demand korechhilam, transformation kore dekhte pelam je eta shotti shotti vector er motoi transform kore.